righty, Buster. We better mosey on back to the ship.
Whoa. Stop the presses.
What?
Looks like old Charlie Charming's got a little business to attend to.
你能搏斗吗? 勇士?
Can I fight?
Hey, give me a quarter.
Why?
I'm gonna find out my future.
Heck yeah, I can fight. Guess I'm kind of a karate master, huh? No big deal.
为什么我在这个白痴上浪费时间?
Sure. Tell your friends about me, huh? Okay, pal. Spread some of that good fortune around.
Sure. But I gotta try out Mr. Punch-Em-Up.
Good luck.
You got another quarter on you?
What do I look like? A bank? Okay, old-timer. What do I got coming my way?
你对这些牌... 有疑问吗?
What's the forecast for the Odyssey back to the States? Smooth sailing? A flower.
Hey, Chuck, we better get back to the ship. We don't want to get stranded.
Come on, man, just let me ask another question.
We really need to get back.
Hey? Hello? Anyone there? Ten? What a dick.
Howdy, Charlie. How's your time off?
Just get me out of here already. What the hell is going on out there? Heard aircraft and gunfire.
Me too. And there was a corpse.
What?
In the sick bay.
Something's wrong. Let's get out of here. What the hell?
What was that? Charlie, help! Fuck no. Yeah, you said it. Fubar and then some.
Thank you.
God damn, another stiff? Who's the lucky winner? Shit. Buckley. Last time I saw him, he was fine. I mean, he was even jonesing for extra security detail.
At least it's not one of us. So, is it just me, or are you getting a real strange feeling right now?
Do I look like a guy who likes to talk about his feelings?
You look like a mess on wheels, Chuck.
I ain't the only one.
Great. Good company.
Let's just get up on deck.
Yeah.
Fine.
Agree.
Yeah.
Chuck, you see that kid over there?
No. You feeling all right?
Oh! Won't you spare me over till another
Hello, and welcome to my repository. I am the curator. The curator of stories. Stories of love and hate, greed and beauty, life and death. Stories such as this one. I'm here to record the story you choose to tell. You see, this tale is only part written, and the choices you make will complete it and determine whether the lives of those with whom you are interfering continue to flourish or whether they are snuffed out. You see, we each make decisions according to our own moral compass, and we have to live with those decisions or die by them. But you shouldn't fear death. It is, after all, inevitable. It is the tax one pays for having lived, and it comes, eventually, to everybody. Still, none of us want for it to come too soon, do we? Sometimes you will be determining the story together, sometimes separately. What one does may not make complete sense to the other because we all have different perspectives. But as in life, the actions you take matter. The choices you make will affect each other. I'll be keeping a close eye on your progress. It's not my place to interfere, but I might be persuaded to offer the occasional hint. Here's one for free. There are pictures in this world that can show you some possible futures. If you can find them and study them, they may just help you to make better decisions. Or should I say, decisions that result in the outcomes you would prefer. That's all for the moment. We'll talk again soon enough. We'll have the opportunity to account for all the actions that you've taken. Or whatever mess you've made.
Think we got enough?
If we run out, we can always call for backup.
So, look. I've never been down there before.
Down?
The water. Diving. Or maybe you could show me how the pros do it.
Dude, of course.
Yeah?
I'm like practically a dive master, man. But I gotta tell you, I'm tough. No special treatment. You gotta do exactly what I say. Well, anyway, let's get this all loaded up.
Whoa, careful. That dive cam is like super expensive.
Little bro, be cool.
What?
Julia and Conrad are, you know, how do I say it? Super fucking loaded?
So?
So don't sweat the little stuff, man. It's not cool. Don't make me regret letting you tag along.
Tag along? Seriously? I thought I was invited.
Brad, you're not on this trip because you're my bro. I mean, you are my brother, but I mean, like, we're buddies, you know?
Kinda.
Just out here to fucking hang, cool out, and kick it.
What the fuck are you talking about?
Let's just kick it and be legends, man. All right, amigo. Calvary's almost here.
Cool.
Sorry I'm a little snappy. I'm just... The new medical school would be stressful, you know?
Total shocker.
And man, the long distance thing with Julia, it's been rough.
It's been like 2 weeks.
Huh? Yep. Right on cue.
What?
Conrad doesn't think we have enough beer.
Ah. I guess I keep these in an undisclosed location.
Yeah. Hey. So, can I get your input on something?
Yeah, what?
Just, kind of a big thing I'm trying to make a decision about.
About finishing med school?
No, but it's just kind of a big life choice, you know? I don't know what's the right thing to do.
You sure you're ready? Give it some thought. Consider all the permutations.
Hey! Oh, sorry. Connie, this is Alex.
Hey.
What's up, man?
Conrad. Watch it, sis. Lady killer, right here.
Good to finally meet you, Conrad. This is Brad, by the way, my little bro.
Hey.
Bradley! Feel like I already know you. I've heard so much about... Yeah.
Yeah, likewise.
Miss me?
Hey, man. Want to crack a cold one with me?
TBH, I kind of have a thing with seasickness.
Bradley. Ray Brattleberry. There's only one way to get your sea legs, and it comes in a can.
Fine. One. That's all.
Right on, Radical. I like the cut of your ship.
It's jib.
Don't ruin it. Where's the old crust bucket skipper anyhow?
I'd invite you to make yourselves at home, but, So is everybody on board and ready to go?
You're selling, I'm buying.
That's it. Get it all out.
Yeah.
You want to go lie down?
Yeah. You know, maybe I should.
Oh, boy.
Let's see those hot picks.
What about over here?
That's pretty far out of the way.
I'm just thinking about backup targets in case we don't find anything on the dive cam.
Listen, to be honest, I've never heard of this wreck you're looking for. Usually these things are crawling with divers.
Yeah.
Well, hot diggity dong. Look at this.
Alex! Come here! I think we got something.
Brad did his homework. If he says a wreck's here, it's here.
Okay, look, you're the client. I'm just saying, we don't have unlimited daylight.
I'm gonna go help Conrad and Julia with the camera. What you got?
Feast your eyes on this.
Brad's calculations were right on the money.
Always bet on Brad.
Yeah, kid's a whiz. We should thank him. Bliss! We found a plane!
Yeah?
Yeah, looks like World War II. We are ready to dive.
Technically, we should call this in to port authorities as an unreported wreck.
Well, technically.
Are you sure you don't want to do this the right way?
Guys, no one knows, no one cares. No harm, no foul. Look, we paid for this dive. Generously, we're diving.
You're the client. But if anything goes wrong...
Oh, I just can't wait to be the first one down there. Can you imagine? Untouched?
should be ready to get you guys in the water in a few.
I'll set up the tanks. The boys will do the final checks. Take a look at the camera, see if you can find anything useful.
Righto.
Hey, maybe you should check on your bro?
Might want to just let it do its thing.
Hey, sis.
Mm-hmm. Hey, Connie, how's it going?
What's up?
Oh, work, work, work. I thought we came on this trip for relaxing to the max.
You've never worked a day in your life.
Excuse me. What I do is hard work. And hardly working.
Yeah, you should see how these rebreathers work if you're planning on diving tomorrow.
Blah, blah, blah. Whatever.
Gotta say, not too happy with our captain at the moment.
Yeah, for real. We paid top dollar to come out here in the middle of nowhere to do whatever the hell we want without any namby-pambies breathing down our neck. That's the good old American way.
I'm serious, Connie. All right, I'm gonna get these rebreathers set up, and then we'll go through the final steps together.
Great. I'm gonna kick back and enjoy the sights for a little while. And by enjoy the sights, I mean I'm gonna ogle our captain like a grade-A creep.
Yeah, I got it. Gross.
Hey, at least I'm honest.
Still gross.
Hey.
Hey, back.
Huh. What am I looking at here?
How you feeling?
Shouldn't have had that beer.
No sweat, Braddy Shack. We'd be hanging up top, should you care to join?
Yeah, I'll be up as soon as I... Stop puke heaving.
Wow, I can't unhear that term. Well, hello. Hello, Locker. What you got inside of you? Interesting. What's this now? Fancy. Good on you, Alex. I think this might be bogus.
Almost got the gear good to go.
Need an extra hand? Never used a rebreather before.
Oh, Captain, my Captain.
It's probably not a bad idea.
You know, we have rules out here for a reason. You guys gotta respect that.
yeah. Sorry about that. My sis can be a little, intense.
That's one way to put it.
That's fair. Just
there are laws here and customs. You gotta respect that. These rules are all pretty basic stuff. How much experience do you have with these kind of dives?
Oh, I got experience.
About the cavalier nature of this dive. For all you know, this could be a war grave. Disturbing it would be illegal and immoral.
Fine. I get it. How much?
How much what?
How much money will it take for you to stop breathing down her necks?
You... This is not about the money. You know what? I can't stop you.
Hey,
just
guys,
respect the rules
already.
Down there. Don't do anything stupid that'll get my ass in trouble.
Conrad, give me a hand.
Okay, so this is the rebreather. Way cooler than a regular scuba setup. It takes all that CO2 that you'd normally just exhale into the water, and instead, it gets totally reused. Then it reduces decompression time on your way up. State of the art. Okay, O2 check done. Whoa, 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 Eager Beaver, you gotta check your O2 first.
Thanks for sending me straight.
Oh, hey, guys.
What? Jesus, why are you so loud?
I almost completely forgot. When I was looking at the dive cam, I saw this huge hole in the tail. Kablooey. That's your way into the plane.
Oh, nice work, man.
Thanks, Conrad.
Okay, you little clownfishes. I'm gonna go see what Fliss is up to.
You behave, Connie.
How's it going?
Are those two going in or what?
Like, I know the wait is interminable, but soon... soon it'll just be you and me.
Out of the frying pan.
All right, kids.
On a shark?
No. Good to go. Just remember the rules, please.
You're on camera. I'll take the wheels.
Let's get a before photo.
that?
More or less. Too bad Fliss is so tight.
She acts like we're going to ransack the plane.
Hey, a souvenir would be cool.
It's not like one tiny little thing would hurt anybody. I won't tell if you won't.
Not like they can scan the wreck every night at sundown. There. That shape. That's gotta be it.
Whoa. That is, like, way bigger than I thought.
Damn. It's pretty intact, too. This is a fucking remarkable find.
Let's swim around a little and find a way in.
Conrad said one of the pictures showed an opening.
The turret. We can get in through there.
Dangerous.
Ladies first? Can I just take a second to say, holy shit, Alex, we did it. I mean, can you believe it? It's a dream come true.
Let's not waste any time not exploring. Go, go, go! Julia, leave it. You'd have to take your gear off to get in there. Not worth it. That pipe's pretty tight. What if you get stuck without your rebreather?
Maybe it is kind of dangerous. Bullet holes, all down the fuselage. Brad's gonna flip when he sees this. Check it out. They reconfigured the bomb rack to hold lifeboats.
Interesting.
One of the rescue boats is missing. Think they were using it?
Let's see what else we can find.
Good God. Ugh. 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 He's holding something. Happen here.
From the look of things, they knew they were goners.
You hear that?
Let's check it out.
And life gives you lemons.
Ew. Pilot and co-pilot. Gotta be. Plane crash not high on my list of ways to perish. Easy now. This stuff's been down here a long time.
Yeah.
Julia! Oh my God! anything else, please.
Holding something. Fuck it. I'm just gonna go for it.
Something stupid down here, that's it. One chance, you get that. We gotta get out of here now. It's a gray reef shark. They're not interested in us. Let's go. Hold on.
Okay. What are you doing? Why are you fidgeting?
I wanted to bring something up with you, but it's not the best time.
What's on your brain, buddy?
Nothing. Just kind of shaken up by a little brush with a gruesome and meaningless death. It doesn't matter. Let's get back up to the top.
Jeez, Alex. You're more of a wreck than that plane that just literally fell apart on top of us.
Give me a break, okay? Come on. We've really got to get up top.
Fliss, this is Julia. We're coming back up. Over. Hey, where'd that other boat come from?
Wait. Julia, we gotta decompress here. Damn!
What the fuck? We gotta get up there.
Wait, we have to decompress.
I'm sorry. My brother's up there. Oh my
God, this is taking too long. This is torture.
Just a few more seconds. Okay, now, go, go!
It's cool, man. Everything's all right now.
There was a little, mishap with the barbecue.
Jesus, looked like the whole boat was lit up. What was up with that other boat?
These fishing guys came by and ran into the dive line. Whatever. Who cares, right? What I want to know is, what'd you guys find?
Well, we found the plane, and it is huge, full of cool stuff. Unfortunately, we did not leave it as pristine as we could have.
What? Why?
The dive line, actually.
How bad?
There's no cockpit anymore, for starters. God.
Well, that's just fucking perfect.
You're getting to know these intrepid adventurers, then. Alex and his little brother, Brad, trying to swim with the big fish, both seem out of their depth. And Julia, the love of Alex's life, and he the love of hers. What about Conrad, a bold fellow, you might say? Or maybe you'd say arrogant. And then there's Captain Fliss, strong, forthright, stubborn. She appears somewhat immune to Conrad's charms, so far at least. Let me reassure you, you help them to make some decisions they'll value later on. You're doing well.
How well preserved was the plane?
Pretty much what you'd expect.
Brad, it was insane. It was like traveling through time.
No shit.
Well, it was like traveling through time and accidentally ending up in a dimension where the past is underwater and, like, everything is covered in barnacles and sharks.
Sharks? It was a great reef.
Ah.
Hey, I thought it was pretty intense.
Wasn't Conrad gonna get us some more beers after he helped Fliss?
Maybe he decided, hey, I'll drink some, and then he got drunk. And since he was drunk, he forgot to bring it to us. And he just kept on drinking, and he drank all of it.
Sounds like you've had some experience with this kind of phenomenon.
Yeah, I've been studying it for years.
I'll go look for him.
Oh, we found a bullet lodged in the plane.
Huh.
I left it below deck if you want to check it out. Hey there, polar bear. You good?
Sorry, I was just thinking about how crazy our dive was. Can you believe what we just got to experience?
No, it was pretty unbelievable. Something up. You can talk to me, really.
I guess I'm just kind of anxious about, like, our future. You know? What's next?
I'll be honest. Lately, I've been wondering about the same thing.
Where do we go from here?
Look, when we get home, we can talk about some stuff, but relax. I mean, it's not like we're breaking up. It's just some stuff we gotta deal with.
Okay. Yeah. Stuff. Got it.
I'm gonna go find Brad and Conrad and Fliss. Hey, you seen my brother? Or Fliss?
No, got distracted.
Let's go get him.
Sure.
So, which one is, you know, where the magic happens?
On behalf of my family, I'd like to apologize for my brother acting like a horny fifth grader.
It's okay. I can deal with children.
Conrad, beers, where are they?
Oh, yeah, the beers. I was just getting them now.
All right, now that everybody's here, let's take a look at the navigator's pad we found. Maybe we can figure out why the plane was out here.
Where'd you put it?
It's in your case.
Okay, I'll go get it.
Hey.
Alex, holy crap. Were you guys, like, in the plane when it broke?
Ooh, got out in the nick of time. Skin of our teeth. Well, our skin was almost in a shark's teeth.
What?
Yeah, didn't I tell you there are sharks around here?
No.
Most of them aren't dangerous.
Oh, yeah, the friendly sharks.
How do you think the day went?
Other than our little tete-a-tete with the locals, pretty good. People always say they have dive experience, but Alex and Julia seem to actually know what they're doing.
So, we're going again tomorrow?
Sign me up. Can't wait to see this sucker for myself.
I'm gonna go find Julia.
Hey, almost time for barbecuing. Got the pad yet?
Oh, no, not yet. I got distracted.
Got it. Let's go up. Come here, you vixen.
Easy, tiger. We should get back. Right here.
You'll get no resistance there. All right, everyone, check it out. Manchurian gold. Who wants to find some sunken treasure? So what do you think, Captain? Coordinates?
Those are coordinates, all right.
Maybe the plane's destination?
You think we could get there by tomorrow?
It takes a couple hours if the weather stays steady.
Wow. You find anything else?
There was a flight plan on board that seemed to indicate it was a rescue plane.
Yeah, that makes sense. After the war, they turned long-range bombers into rescue planes.
And then this plane must have been shot down because it was riddled with bullet holes. I found one lodged in the fuselage.
Huh.
And it was full of life rafts. Must have gotten shot down before they could deliver all the rafts. There was only one missing.
From the photos Alex took, you can see the flight badge on one of the corpses. That means the crew was from the Conwin Island, smack dab in the middle of the Pacific Theater. Called it.
Reckless, all of you.
Excuse me?
I told you to leave everything down there alone.
Oh, come on. We've been through this already.
I'm not talking about the law.
Then what? Superstition? Is that it? Really?
The dead don't sleep well in these waters. May sound silly enough to you all, but I was raised on this shit, and it sticks.
Oh, come on. No one knows we've even been down there, and I don't think ghosts can talk.
You Americans are all the same, huh? No respect for anyone else's traditions. You should have never gone down to that plane in the first place. It's bad luck. You think you can scavenge down there and it makes no difference, but every single thing you bring back has an essence. It's like a ghost you invite to the surface.
Here we go.
Huh. I never thought about it like that.
You never think about much of anything.
Well, maybe I never heard about such cool ghost stories.
They're not cool ghost stories. Not like for fun. People drown in these waters and you have to respect their resting place.
Damn straight. Brad, you got a fun ghost story, right?
Tell us a tale.
Let's hear it. I bet you can spin a good yarn.
It's kind of messed up, actually.
Scare away, little bro.
Okay, here goes. This story is true. It had happened right near here, in an old lighthouse.
Classic setup.
Wait, true story? Where'd you hear this?
If you need to know, it's ripped right from the rotting pages of the terrifying ancient in-flight magazine I was perusing on our way here. The lighthouse stood atop an atoll, isolated from the rest of the world, a lone beacon in the night, a sailor's respite. The lighthouse keeper would hear the waves pounding the rocky shore. One misty morning, he comes upon a woman covered in blood. She's stumbling down the beach. He hurries to her aid and she falls into his arms, sobbing. As he hurries her back to the lighthouse, he asks where she's from.
He doesn't waste any time. Smooth.
Shh. The woman answers, I live here, in the lighthouse. My parents are upstairs right now.
Twist.
Of course, the lighthouse keeper says, that isn't so. Of course, he's lived there alone for years. And the woman becomes hysterical and insists her parents are upstairs. So, they go to the top of the lighthouse, and there, splayed out on the floor, is a man and a woman brutally murdered with an axe.
Always an axe. I mean, do people even use axes anymore?
Okay, fine. Then it was a meat hook. They were slashed with a meat hook and hung from the rafters.
Wait a minute. Are you changing the murder weapon? I thought this was a true story.
There's a lot of blood. A lot of carnage. Who's to say how it was done?
Okay, so who did it?
I suspect it was the woman's maniac brother did the deed.
Oh, great. Blame the brother.
So the lighthouse keeper creeps over to the closet, opens the door, and sure enough, there's a man inside. But he sliced out his own insides with a meat hook. Horrified. He looks closer to see the dead man's face in the dark. Closer. Closer. And he sees. It's his own face. And then its eyes bulge out and screams.
Yeah, so gross.
That's horrible.
Hey, well, super twist.
Nice.
Nice one, Squire.
I think you told it better last time, but good effort.
Okay, you've all had your fun. We should all turn in. There's some weather heading our way.
No, because according to standard vessel regulation, we're all required one more beer before hitting the hay.
What regulations are these?
It's standard issue regulatory institutional protocol subdivision 1099.
Uh-huh. Where'd you read that?
The internet.
Oh, so you found a website that tells you to drink beer under every circumstance.
I'm just following orders, man.
I'm into this website.
10-4, good buddy.
And I'm out.
Good news, bad news.
Bad news? I don't see how this could get any worse.
The bad news is these are kind of maybe the fishermen I pissed off earlier.
Oh, God damn it, Conrad.
Great, just great. And the good news?
I recognize them.
How was that good news?
I thought you were going to ask the good news first.
You're such an idiot, Jesus.
We have to get free right now.
I'll be back for you later.
Conrad!
You're the little lady.
What's happening? Can you see?
God, Julia. They're beating the piss out of Conrad. We gotta get out of here. What are they talking about?
Who gives a fuck? I'm gonna kill every one of them.
We can't just blindly attack them. We need a plan that can take them all out at once.
We need to get free. First things first.
Slow down. Easy.
Jesus, Conrad. Wait, no! Alex!
Stop it! Let her know! You bastards!
Hey. Dipstick. Shut the fuck up.
Hey. Dollars to donuts, it'll be Fliss and Julia breaking heads. Not the other way around.
Fliss sure seems to be getting buddy-buddy with him. Did you see my brother?
No, I didn't. I hope he's all right.
All right. Turn around. Don't let them see your hands. Once we get Julia back, maybe we can take them by surprise. Okay, they're coming.
Fuck! Motherfuckers!
Julia, tell me what happened.
They asked about our parents.
What?
How much money they have. Just have to wait and see what they want to do with us.
Eight seconds. The storm's 8 miles away.
They came here on a boat. Maybe we can take it.
Yeah. Yeah, it's a speedboat.
The main guy here, he's got a gun.
Well, at least one of us can get on their boat. Get some help.
These fuckers need to pay. We gotta take them down. They can try to fight back, but if we had the gun, they'd be forced to surrender. 7 seconds. I can get out through the window. We gotta break these off first.
Too loud. They'll hear it.
We're gonna break them during the thunder.
Good call.
I'll climb out this window, take a look around.
Just scope it out.
You guys distract them so they don't see me sneaking.
Okay, let's do it.
About what you're doing, boy.
Let's finish this.
This kid's trying to kill me, old son.
Thank you.
boat.
Ha! Your boat? I'm the captain now. If you have to.
Sit down. Over there. You, right here. Sit. Now.
Arrêtez, bande de cons! C'est mon bateau! Stop!
Ferme-la, ou je te mets mon poing dans la gueule!
Which one of you is going to tell me about this Manchurian gold?
Give me your best shot.
All right! Shut the fuck up!
Oh, give me a break with that gangster shit.
I don't think you fully comprehend the severity of your situation, sister.
Hey, come on. We're just passing time. No big deal.
Keep quiet. Captain says shut your mouth. You shut your mouth.
Sit still, all of you.
You, come with me.
Hey, leave her alone.
Talking to you.
You and your friends had no right to come on our boat and do this.
Just shut up.
What the hell is going on, Alex?
We need to keep an eye on Fliss. She's helping them. She's gotta be.
You really think she is?
That's enough. No talking. This ain't summer camp.
Couldn't talk at summer camp either.
And? What do you want?
Wanna point that thing somewhere else? What if it goes off by accident?
No such thing.
No.
And talking to you.
Thank you.
Hey! Move it! Now!
Thanks, I guess. What happened? Anyone know about Brad? Is he hiding somewhere?
I don't know where he is.
We can't leave him down there. He could drown.
We need to get him out of there. He's not safe. Brad, buddy, come out.
Move.
Everyone's still alive. Things could have been quite different. Kind-hearted creature I am, I'd like to offer you some forewarning of what's to come. Tempted? One of you says yes, and one of you says no. If you could learn to work together, then things might turn out more beneficially. Anyway, now that you've reached a point of significant distress, I presume you're eager to get back to your story. But here's a thing. Everything may not be entirely as it seems. Probably shouldn't have said that.
La porte! La porte! Vite! La porte!
Go on, keep moving.
dans ce navire.
Cet endroit, c'est un foutu cimetière.
J'espère qu'on est les seuls ici.
Olaya, over there.
Not sign up for a trip to Creep Town.
Something about this place is making my hair stick up so far it's gonna jump out of my neck.
Pourquoi on se tire pas d'ici? Préférerais n'importe où ici. Vraiment envie de savoir ce qu'on va découvrir.
Fermez-la. On continue. Move!
Orson, il y a une porte ici.
Ok, all of you, into the room.
Hey, it's pitch black in here. Give us the light.
What is this fucking place?
Dude, even those meatheads seem spooked.
You think this ship is the Manchurian Gold?
We are in the vicinity of those coordinates.
We can't just sit around. We need a plan.
Yeah. We're not exactly in the best position to be making any moves.
The second they let their guard down, we gotta take advantage of it and get off the ship.
Yeah, man. This whole rust bucket's one tetanus shot from the bottom of the ocean.
Yeah, we gotta stay sharp and keep our eyes out for the right moment.
They swiped our distributor cap. Gonna be difficult to get anywhere without it.
So, okay, what exactly is a distributor cap? Now pretend you're talking to someone who doesn't know anything about boats.
Well, typically, a distributor cap is designed to distribute voltage from the coil to the correct rotor, which in turn... It's an essential part of the engine. We're not taking the Duke of Milan anywhere without it.
While those guys are out panning for Manchurian gold or whatever they think they're gonna find on this floating coffin, we gotta take advantage and look around for a way out of here.
et j'ai pas les outils pour y arriver.
Fais ce que je te dis, et c'est tout.
So, when we told you this would be a quick little adventure...
Was there...
Hey. I found a letter. A really weird letter. Some of the crew were really wigged out by the cargo.
Wigged out? By what?
With the guy Miller who wrote...
Real creepy. Figures? Ooh, spooky. Like ghosts?
He said he thought the rest of the guys were...
All right, boss man. What's the plan?
What the hell was actually going on?
I don't know what these guys are gonna do with us.
Hey, keep your eyes peeled for another, opportunity. You feel me?
I mean, there's definitely something creepy about this place. This letter's just proof that someone else felt it too.
Something just feels wrong about this whole ship. I just wish I knew what the fishermen were planning.
What happened here?
Plan? These guys do not seem like the planning type.
I heard them say something about robbing the Duke, that this whole thing was just supposed to be a robbery, but once they heard about the gold, they went and got in over their heads.
Warren's not gonna help. We gotta figure out how to get out of here.
What's going on?
So, what do we do?
The way I see it, we got two options. We sneak out or we stay here and fight. Simple as that.
Sneaking out is a better option, but I just don't know how we're gonna do it. Okay, well, we're not gonna do anything from in here. We need to keep looking around and try to find a way out.
I'll take a look around.
All right, yeah, catch you later. Why this was ripped off.
Tu restes ici et tu surveilles les prisonniers. Prisonniers? On est en prison? On sera bientôt riche si vous la fermez. Et si vous faites ce que je vous dis de faire.
Il y a quelque chose qui cloche ici.
Je sais pas. Come take a look.
On se retrouve coincé sur ce ratio de merde qui pue la mort. Et on a des prisonniers? Ça va trop loin, tout ça.
Vos gueules! Fermez-la, tous les deux. Je suis votre capitaine, et je vous ordonne d'obéir à mes ordres.
Any luck?
I can't get it open.
Hey!
We could bust it open. Freedom.
Whoa. We don't know where an event like this would go.
I think we just gotta find out.
You want me to just smash through this wall? Okay, then I'll take your silence as a yes. Someone should create a distraction. This is gonna be loud.
Yeah, okay. Conrad, you do it.
Hey.
Stop!
Are we safe now?
No, fuck that. We have to go back for Fliss. I'm the reason she got snagged.
Yep, gotta get her.
No way. No heroics. We gotta get as far away from here as we can.
Shit. You're right. There's the mystery of the smelling socks. Where's the "you are here" arrow?
What is this place?
Engine room.
Well, is there anything we can use down here?
We're gonna need the distributor cap back before we're gonna get out of here.
Well, that's a lot of people who are suspiciously nowhere to be found.
Maybe everyone's hiding in the hole for a big surprise party.
So freaked out.
It's okay. I'll protect you.
I wonder if Fliss is okay.
She's a tough cookie.
What are they doing to her?
Jay, you're gonna drive yourself crazy. Just hope for the best, okay?
for something moving. Down there. Yeah. There's someone down there, all right. The distributor cap? From the Duke? We should grab it.
Our son!
Okay. I'm going for it. We gotta think this through, man.
Oh my God, will you wait? Holy crap.
Ok. Qui est là? Je vous ai entendu. Qui est là?
Arrête de crier, j'essaie d'entendre ce qui se passe.
Je crie pas.
Ta gueule. Je veux savoir où sont les autres.
All right. I see you. Come on. Step out. Stand over there with her.
We're gonna follow them. Don't let them out of your sight. What are we doing? I thought we were following them. We
gotta keep our distance. This way we can get ahead of them.
Let's hope it's faster.
I got this. the makeshift chapel.
Oh, good God. Why do I need to see this now? What was that? You hear that?
Maybe we hit an iceberg.
Not funny. Wait a minute. We've been here before.
I don't think so.
Oh, I swear we've been here before, Alex. Have you been leading us in circles?
Come on, guys. We gotta keep moving.
What?
Jesus! God!
Alex? What is it?
Nothing. You don't want to know.
What? What does that mean? Why aren't you telling me?
Soup du jour, mademoiselle?
As if you know your way around a kitchen.
Please, relax. Just messing around.
This place.
I'm thinking we gotta go through here. What was that?
I didn't hear anything.
Maybe you should get your ears examined, bud.
This isn't right.
What? What?
There's something in here with us. Didn't you? I mean, did you hear anything?
All right, well, we should keep moving.
I know I saw something. It was moving in the shadows.
Rats. Probably just rats. That's all it was.
Don't fucking laugh at me!
What do you want to do? Turn around?
We've seen all this before.
Cool it, Jay. We don't have a lot.
Okay, no. This isn't working for me.
What?
Gross caskets and crappy chapels? Not my scene, you know?
You're right. It's gross and it's crappy. Gotta get out of here toot sweet.
And we gotta find Fliss.
Okay, so can we just get the fuck out then? What is this?
Hey, we got a name on this guy.
What are they even doing here? I don't think stuck on a ghost ship for all eternity sounds like a good plan, eh?
Who cares where they're from or where they're going? They're dead and we're not, so let's keep it that way.
Look at this one. Like for a kid or something.
I don't want to know. Let's get out of here.
Yes! Maybe that's little baby Dracula. Right there. And those are his parents, and they're lying in the dirt from their native country.
And then they all jump on Conrad and eat off his face. The end.
Got some serious locks in these caskets.
Why would they be chained and locked?
Well, that's one way to end a relationship.
Oh, this? I was practically falling off anyway.
You know what? Don't lie to me. Not even for my own good. What is it?
Look!
What?
Seriously? Are you trying to freak me out?
Huh?
Can we just get out of here? Can we please hurry? I'm done sightseeing.
Roger that.
We gotta get Fliss. No time to lose.
What the hell is making that sound?
What sound?
Whoa. Why so spick and span? Fuck!
Hey, this is no time to be fucking around. I'm serious. I can't take it. Why did you touch it? Connie? Connie! Connie, where the fuck are you? Where is Conrad?
He must have gone on ahead.
Connie!
Shh, shh, quiet.
I can shout if I want. Connie! Where the hell did he go?
Are you sure you know where we're going? Fliss? Fliss? Hello? Fliss? Fliss? Where'd you go? Great. All these hallways look exactly alike.
Hey.
Fliss, hey! Where were you? weird. You absolutely sure?
Shut up and keep moving. Just keep on moving.
Oh, hell.
What? No, no, no. Alex? No! What?
Who's that? Who's there? Get away! Alex? Julia?
You okay?
Thanks. I could have drowned. I'm sorry, but you did the right thing. It was him or us.
Fuck!
You wanted to surprise me with the whole pirate adventure thing, and I gotta say it was a good idea. No, it was. I mean, it's funny. I think it's funny, but I think the guys you hired are taking it a little too far, maybe. And don't be cheap. I mean, you didn't feel like paying top dollar, and that's what you get. You get these guys that are not cream of the crop. They're taking it a little too far. You know, you get my drift? So if you want to feel free to pull the old plug, get rid of these guys.
Thank you.
and something... something is fucking with me. I gotta find everybody. Whatever this is, it's fucking with me, okay? It's fucking with me. Probably not much of a practice we could preach kind of guy. If anybody knew what the hell was going on in this place, it would have been the captain. Yeah, I should really take a look behind this door, shouldn't I? Should. But should I? Yeah, I should. Well, all right. So how do I pry this son of a bitch open? Got some heft at least. Enough for the door.
Damn, you scared the hell out of me.
Wow, that was intense.
That's one way to put it.
We got a better way.
What does this mean? Is the war over?
We gotta get somewhere safe.
good here?
We're good, I think.
Oh, hello. Things appear to have taken a turn towards the spiritual, wouldn't you say? Have you figured out what's going on? How to stop it? How to save the lives of your poor, unfortunate stowaways? You will, I hope. Although it seems the ship's previous occupants never managed to. Quite a lot of deaths that night. Let me help you out. Give you a little hint. No hint? Perhaps you think you can piece things together from the clues you've found yourself. Good luck with that. Perhaps you've started to realize something. That everything and everyone may not be quite what they appear to be. I hope that helps. Well, aren't you excited to find out what your poor unfortunates are making of all this and how you might avoid any more unnecessary tragedy? Go on, back to it. Speak soon.
What the hell was wrong with you back there? Brad, you lost your shit, like, big time. You almost killed me.
Down there.
Let's just stay calm and relatively sane about this, okay?
The stuff I saw, it's like there were these old soldiers. They were bodies. They were dead, but then they came alive and...
That... doesn't sound that crazy right about now.
I saw something. This old lady. I mean, she was batshit crazy and like dinosaur old. Not that that's a bad thing, but she just, like, up and vanished on me.
Alex wasn't the only Alex.
What are you talking about?
There were things walking around with his face on them. Alex's face, it was horrifying.
Julia, I'd never hurt you. You know that, right?
No, I know. It's just...
Let's time out, okay? This place is too fucked up to just be fucked up. You know what I'm saying? I mean, like, something is going on here. So what do we know for sure that we can all agree on?
Am I crazy, or are we on a ghost ship? Like, ghost ships are real, and this is one, and we're totally on it, and oh, holy shit, we're so totally fucked?
I was gonna say the same thing. Anyone figure out what happened to all the sailors? Did they catch a rescue boat or something?
You can smell death everywhere. It's like a tomb.
So what's with the bodies? They come with the ship?
They actually look like they've been scared to death.
This whole place reeks of weird. Dirty, stinky, weird. And I don't like it.
It's like this place is stuck in a perpetual bad feeling machine.
What do you think actually happened on this ship?
I haven't got a clue.
The ship was bound for San Francisco, but it hailed from a water purification plant in China. Apparently that's where it picked up the Manchurian gold.
I saw 1947 on the newspaper.
We know more than we did before. That's something, at least.
We're wasting time. Whatever we do, we have to do it now.
Time to get off this ship.
We're not going anywhere without the distributor cap. The Duke needs it to run.
Hold on. The ship's gotta have a radio. If we can find it and use it...
That's great, but do you think it still works?
Just need to find a way up there. We gotta get off this damn ship.
No shit. I think we're, speaking clinically, totally effed.
I know it's kind of crazy, but I wonder if the plane from the dive could have been shot down by this ship. Well, these are ruined. Can't use them.
Find a way up?
Sadly, no, but I'll keep my eyes open. Wonderful. Instructions on how to use a gas mask. No mention of disintegration.
Hey, a little help over here. I think this is our way up. Give me a lift. I'll pull you up.
This is where I chased Conrad before.
Huh. I thought it looked familiar.
Hey, come here. Here's a way true.
Find a radio yet?
No, but there's gotta be a radio on this ship. There has to be.
I'm not exactly confident about our chances of survival at this point.
Blown off course, bad cloud cover, but they couldn't get a read on their bearings.
Thank you.
Oh, dear God. He died trying to get an SOS out.
Take a look.
No freaking way. This thing actually still works?
Well, radio science hasn't changed much in 70 years, as long as there's power.
Ah, it's working!
It's a number station. Military bandwidth.
Let's ask them for help. Hey! Hey! Is anyone out there hearing this? Hello?
Received. Over.
Holy shit! We got him! If you can hear us, we're on a ship, an old freighter. Our coordinates are approximately 12 degrees 30 minutes south, 151 degrees 20 minutes west. Please, get here now. We need help.
Please repeat. Over.
We're on this, like, old freighter. We think the name of it is the Iran Medan. Hello? Hello? Is anyone out there? Please, come in.
Yo, guys, check it out.
This has got to lead somewhere. Maybe we can find a way to get the power back.
We need to get that radio working.
I think someone should wait here in case a message comes through.
I gotta be honest. I don't think I'm gonna make it down there in my shape.
I'll go, obviously.
I can do this. I should be the one to go.
Hey, if you're sure you're up for it... No.
Not my bodyguard. I can take care of myself. Then that's that. I'm going.
Okay, Julia. It's you and I.
Broken bones? Everything still work?
Everyone okay?
We're okay.
What are we gonna do?
We gotta find out where we are.
Okay, we'll wait here by the radio. Here.
Hey.
After you.
Guessing these are the lower levels of the ship.
Someone named Joe was in sickbay.
Some sort of altercation. 10 days on the break. Wow. Must have really blown his lid to get that kind of time. I wish I could actually, you know, enjoy this.
What the hell are you talking about?
Well, in any other circumstance, you know, this place would be the coolest place to explore, like ever.
I'm gonna say no, not at all.
Says the girl who couldn't wait to dive a wreck.
Shut up. Oh, barf. Maybe this was somebody's son from on board? Look at this.
Looks like the engine room.
Good place to find a generator, right?
The ladder's broken off here. I think I can just...
Wait! Are you okay?
Yeah, all good. Just come down.
What's up?
That, wait, didn't you see it?
Hello?
Okay, so I'm seeing things, but you're not. Okay, so follow my thinking here. We know this ship was carrying the Manchurian gold, but that was really some sort of hallucinogenic bioweapon developed in China during World War II. And we know that it was super unstable and leaked all over the ship. So maybe it's still here? Maybe it hasn't dispersed after 70 years, and it's having the same effect on us, you know? Paranoid hallucinations. All this crazy shit we're seeing, none of it's real.
The crew was hallucinating. We know they were scared of something, and the officers thought it was just a bunch of jumpy GIs trying to get out of guard duty.
This isn't a ghost ship, it's a floating bioweapon.
This couldn't have anything to do with the plane wreck we dived.
I mean, maybe there was a connection? Maybe they made contact? It's a theory, I guess.
Oh, God. All right, let's get going.
Thank you.
You know what I miss right now?
Dry clothes?
Yeah. Was anchored according to this.
Wonder why.
Hey, I found it!
Oh, thank God. And it's working! Yep, this is it, all right. Just throw the switch and let's get back upstairs.
Okay, let's get back upstairs. There's gotta be another way up.
We lost power, but we have it back. Can you hear me? Over! We need help, now! There are things on the ship that are trying to hurt us. Over!
Recovery mission is en route to your location. Over. Location is confirmed.
Oh, come on, work, damn it!
Fisherman must have brought it over from the Duke of Milan.
You think it still works?
Looks like it's got a little juice left. Maybe a couple of minutes. Should we bring it with us? I mean, it's heavy.
Hell yeah, we should. Half the boat is submerged.
Salaud! Je sais ce que tu essaies de faire! Tu veux me tuer? Hein? Mais c'est moi qui vais te tuer! Dis-moi seulement où est-ce que tu t'endors! T'es-tu de la fermer, sale menteur? Ferme ta gueule de merde! Tu dis n'importe quoi! Tout ce que tu racontes, c'est des conneries! Alors, ferme ta sale gueule de merde!
Les esprits morts viennent me chercher.
I think we should try to avoid that.
Yeah.
No use hiding, you little foot. What's the problem with sharing all that gold, eh? There must be plenty of that to go around, more than enough. And we're all in this together, right? Trying to cut me out of the deal? You can't have all the gold. And I'm to be left here to die. But I am the captain. I am in control. And I am the one that says who goes and who stays. Ah!
He's breathing down our necks. Please tell me you have an escape plan.
Yeah, totally. I mean, these doors were meant to withstand all sorts of stuff.
Okay. Okay. None of you move. None of you go all changing on me now. Turn around. Slow. Real slow.
Oh.
Okay. All right. Not changing. None of that. Raise your hands up. Slow. No, no. Not like that. I said, no changing.
Please, we've got no problem with you. We just want to get out of here. Please.
I'm sorry, but if you're breathing, then you don't got much of a choice in the matter. You don't got a say. Ah! Not again! It's all got changing on me!
What? What's changing?
Stay away! Stay back from the mist!
What? There's no mist, man!
Don't breathe it! Don't breathe the mist!
Why can't we breathe the mist? What does it do?
It's life. Bringing things to life that shouldn't be alive. It's inside now. Inside with us now.
Please just calm down.
Stop! Stop! It's in one of us, isn't it?
I haven't breathed any weird mist. Please, I promise.
Yeah, you breathed in the mist. It's happening. I can feel it.
Come on, man. There is no mist.
Oh.
Wait by the radio.
Why?
I'm gonna check the next level. There might be some more gear down there we can use. I'm not going far. Just wait by the radio.
I'm gonna hang back here as well.
Just stay by the radio. Don't run away.
I wouldn't dream.
Over here.
This must have been what we just heard.
Oh no, what's that?
Doesn't matter. We need that distributor cap. Here! He had to have come this way.
Sure. gonna make this jump, Alex. I'll have to find another way around.
You.
Hey, what the hell is your problem? Put the knife down, Alex. That's an order. It's okay.
Oh my god. Oh my god. Fliss. Gotcha.
All right, let's try it. All right.
He had this thing where if I was ever upset or disappointed, he would tell me this crazy bullshit about all the different parallel realities that could potentially exist. Now, no matter what, no matter how bad things seemed, there were always at least a couple other realities where things were probably even worse. Well, you were right, little bro.
That's it. Game over. You're done. For now, at least. You could always try again, see if you can't do better next time around. Impressive. Almost everyone survived. Almost. Things became a little intense, but Alex kept his nerve. Well done, Alex. Well done, you. It's all about decisions, isn't it? Decisions made in a hurry, in a panic, made with the heart instead of the head, or vice versa. Sometimes those decisions take a long time to have repercussions. But there are repercussions. There are always repercussions. Till we meet again, maybe in Little Hope, maybe somewhere else. But be certain, we will meet again. It's inevitable.
Want to spare me over till another year? Want to spare me over till another year? Want to spare me over till another year? Want to spare me over till another year?
So out of nowhere, this thing just sent out an SOS. Guess we got a real live ghost ship here. Whoa. What the hell is this?
I just saw someone in the woods.
Whoever it was, they're gone.
Okay, very good. Who's there?
I fashioned her with my own hand.